Tyler Merriam with you from Lewis and Clark Park. We are in Sioux City, Iowa this evening as South Dakota State and Creighton prepare to meet for the second time this season. Ed Service got the better of Dave Schreck as the Blue Jays a 4-2 winner a little more than a month ago. Digs into his glove for his baseball, has it in the 1-2 on the inside corner at the knees, called strike three. Including the two and the three men, Coppola and Luke Ringhoff. 2-1 pitch in the air down the left field line. Landon Lukanski on the run, diving, and came up with it in fair territory for the out. Nice play by Lukanski. Comes set just below the chin, the 2-2. Danforth, a bouncer to the right side. That'll get into right field for a base hit. One run scores. Matt Johnson around third. Connolly's throw is cut off. Two-run single. A ground ball with eyes into right for Eric Danforth. And the Jackrabbits have a 2-0 lead. As Kinkle trying to survive another scare, the 0-1. Breaking ball hit high and deep to right center. Coppola backing up. He'll have room in front of the track. Tagging from third, Woodrow will score. Tagging from second, Lopez. And he'll slide a third without a throw. And Creighton has cut the lead in half. Brett Murray, a sacrifice fly, RBI number 20 on the year. Back of the plate. Fiedelman's 1-0, high in the air, deep to center. This will tie the game. Coppola, he'll make the play. Tagging from third, Woodrow. The throw is cut off. And Daniel Woodrow will score on the sack fly by Brett Murray. Two on, two gone, the 0-2. Breaking ball, liner into shallow center field. That's a base hit. Being waved around third as Clary. Throw to the plate by the first baseman Fowler on the relay is not in time. Scoring is Reed Clary, and the Jackrabbits have a 3-2 lead. Matt Johnson at second, Al Robbins at first. Stretch by Lukowski in the 0-1. Roller off the end of the bat, diving play by the first baseman, Reagan Fowler, and he'll take it himself to Rob Johnson. Fitzgerald down the line from third, Weideman away from first where Matt Johnson holds him. He goes, the 3-1, bouncing ball up the middle. Huff will go to second, doesn't get him. Now the throw home is late, and everybody is safe. Jumper stepped into a mess and trying to escape it. The 1-0. Big chopper to first. Matt Johnson will throw home. Low throw. Clary couldn't dig it out. One run will score. And it caught Clary up around the throat, it appeared, at the top of the chest. It might have even gotten him in the mouth, actually. Who singled in the fifth. It's a slow bouncer to first. Matt Johnson this time will simply take it to first himself on the slow bouncer. But Connolly will score. Three have touched home plate here in the sixth for Creighton, and the Blue Jays lead it 5-3. First and second, and one away. Last of the sixth, the Jacks trailing at 5-3. Runners will go. Ringhoffer lines one into right field, base hit. Jacobson scores easily, and Coppola goes to third. It's a 5-4 ball game, and they're on the corners with one away. Runners on the corners, one away. Stretch by Heiberger, 2-1. Clary, the squeeze, gets it down. Heiberger didn't have a chance to come home with it. Coppola will score the tying run as Heiberger throws to first. 2-2 from jumper. Runner goes. Pitch hit in the air, straightaway center. Coppola under it. Coming on, makes the play. Crawford tags. Coppola's throw is online, and Clary couldn't come up with it, but the runner Crawford just did graze home plate. It's a sack fly, and the Blue Jays have the lead. Clary wigwags a side out to jumper, who has it. He'll peek at second, and the righty's 2-1. Hit high in the air and deep to right center. Coppola racing back. This ball is over his head, and it one hops off the fence. Around second, Hiranski digging for third. Schneider's relay is in time. It's an RBI double to score Fitzgerald, but the Jackrabbits gun down the runner Hiranski. It's another outfield assist for Coppola and the two up. That's line into left field. Jacobson coming on. He won't be able to get there, though. It's a base hit. Lopez will score. And Creighton has opened up the lead. It's now 8-5. Blue Jays in the eighth. And IPFW, non-division one wins. There's a liner into left center. Woodrow on the run. He reaches up. It's over his head. Robbins goes the other way, and it rolls all the way to the wall. He's into second. He's being waved around. The throw to third is online and in time. Lopez to Crawford. And Al Robbins is gunned down at third to end the game. It is his eighth double of the year, but Woodrow, Lopez, Crawford takes care of him at third as the Jacks take a risk, and Robbins is gunned down to end the game.
We didn't make the routine plays that we've been making all season long. You know, we had a ground ball back to the pitcher, ground ball to first base. Had a chance to throw a guy out at the plate, didn't hang on to a ball. So, I mean, it wasn't one of our better performances of the season. And just didn't think we came out with a lot of energy and a lot of focus tonight. But, you know, we got a battle back. We got a conference weekend ahead. So, we got a choice to make if we want to play hard starting this weekend. Well, we really appreciate the turnout that we had tonight. It was a great crowd. A lot of fans came out. I want to thank our administration for coming down here and really trying to promote the game. And I thought we had a really nice crowd. It was a nice event. The first thing I'm looking forward to is practice tomorrow because we need to get our energy straight and we need to get our focus back going if we're going to compete against Western Illinois, because if we played like we did tonight, we're going to be in trouble. So it starts with our focus at practice tomorrow.